One in 10 people trying to cross the Auckland border today were turned around because they didn't have proof of a COVID-19 test. It's been put down to a lack of awareness about the new requirement, which came into force overnight. This comes as more Aucklanders were also found abusing essential worker status to get out. Laura James reports.
We've got a COVID test.
Car after car caught out.
You have got a COVID test, haven't you?
Yes, every 7 days.
One News watched as many were turned around at the Auckland border today with no proof they'd been swapped.
You don't have to pass a COVID test, but you have to have proof that you have undertaken one, and it has to be within 7 days.
It was around 10% of people who had been coming to the border had been asked to go back and get a test. That's perhaps not unexpected on the first full day. We've established, particularly at the southern border, we've established the ability for people to turn around and go to a very nearby venue to get their test.
It's certainly not intentional non-compliance. I think that there's a need for Kiwis, particularly in these COVID times, to be able to get to work. I can only assume in these cases that people are not aware of the rules. And so it's up to employers to, you know, inform their staff.
The need for the new testing rules being highlighted after an Auckland truck driver tested positive.
I can confirm that he travelled in his work capacity to a number of supermarkets in Auckland, the Waikato and Bay of Plenty regions.
That travel permitted, but others continue to abuse their essential worker status. One student travelling to Taranaki to attend their course.
Then he travelled back on business travel documents that allowed him to leave Auckland. We checked those documents and he was immediately removed from class and put into a self-isolation.
Meanwhile, more anger over just who can get exemptions to cross the boundary. Silver Ferns players permitted to leave, but not those who've lost family like Amy Sinclair.
And we applied for exemptions. We went out and got COVID tests which returned negative. Why do we have the options to accompany our tūpapaku home when our reasons aren't valid?
I accept that for people in those situations, this is a very distressing and difficult time. And this is a decision the Director General makes. We have to trust his judgment in these matters.
Amy says she's among hundreds who don't think it's fair.
And Laura is with us now. Kia ora, Laura. What is the message from police to motorists?
Police say some people were stopped because and turned around because they didn't have the proof of their test. Some had proof that was more than 7 days old. But no matter that the case, they say they're going to continue to stop and check that drivers have the necessary evidence. And that can be in the form of a text or on paper.
Laura James in Auckland, thank you.